to Chapel. Yeah. And everyone looked at me like, what are you doing?
I mean, wetter than a man thrown overboard. Yeah. I mean, my goodness. God.
Yeah, wetter than a skinny dipper, too. Yeah, I mean, look, we got a few more coming. Hey, I appreciate y'all. We having some fun out here as we get this one underway. We might have a few more Kyle-isms. It's Terry Taylor. Oh, he lets it fly. Tutu was on. You know, Taylor's a bucket, too. He had he averaged 8 points per game through pool play.
He's fifth in scoring. He's got it done scoring the ball.
Well, 20 and 10 career numbers for him. He's an OVC two-time player of the year. Okay.
Stay with him.
All right. There's Chef Boy Jardine. Mm. He's got the recipe.
He's had a nice tournament.
Oh.
Hot players, certainly. Everything's going in.
The bank is open. Oh, Brown. You forgot something. You might need it. It's going over the red now.
Another look. Boy at Chef.
Yeah, Jardine. Cash me outside. Speaking of outside.
Does Jardine have the best nickname here in the tournament?
Yeah, I put him in the pole position so far.
He's got to be the fave.
Yeah. There's Pyle. Get to the rim, getting a bucket. Jardine scoop. No. Nino. Josiah Wallace. Takes a little bump and fades away. And he gets it to trickle in.
Pretty well defended by Cody John.
Yeah, pretty good pace to start this too, 7-4. Oh, he rocked him to another land.
Revenge is so sweet.
You saw the right to left, Robbie?
A crossover.
Oh, no.
Breaking him off.
Wallace. Man. Kisses that one off the glass. Tough shot.
You haven't seen him score a ton, but here early, he is really looking for his offense.
Yeah, he has been he's been relatively quiet. No better time than today to make some noise.
And Pyle, sorry about you. Crossover by Cody John is nasty.
Terry Scanlon is in, former Belmont Bruin. We had a good combo with him on the elevator yesterday. He's like, yeah, they hit me up and asked me, I don't want to play. I was,
sure.
Working. I was working, and I said, sure.
One of our 2020 guys.
Yeah. Scanlon kicks it. Taylor. Not made. Two and a half minutes in. It is Championship Sunday here for the 3x3U National Championship presented by Dos Equis. Kyle Montgomery, Robbie Hummel in your ear. Duffel bag boys standing by in the Dos Equis Lounge.
Oh, good defense. Yeah. Isaiah Brown locking in.
He got his pockets raw.
I know we've talked about this, but Terry Taylor literally looks like he could play for, like, the Dallas Cowboys.
Does he not play for the Cowboys? I mean, I thought.
He might soon. 6'5", 230. We got Headband Terry back in the building.
He's man size. He had a man-sized game yesterday, too. 15
yeah,
points.
It's the highest scoring game of all the action.
Yeah, five doubles in that game. Brown misses the crib, but he cleans up his own mess. One possession contest. Scanlon, no hesitation on the release, but he didn't put enough on it.
Chef going down.
So Summit Valley Open, they are your 8th seed, finished with a 1-6 record. Their only win was against Big Maction, 22-15. Western Skywalkers here trailing by two. Get that mess up out of here.
Pyle.
Yeah.
Coming over with some help side defense. Isaiah Brown thought he had a layup, and Matt Pyle had other ideas.
Yeah, quick swipe out of bounds. Oh, yeah.
I was going to say, he didn't get that off.
He didn't get it off. love the sound of those nets, though.
Yeah, when it's pure and it kind of tings the back of the rim, it's a good sound.
Western Skywalker's a 5 seed out of Pool A. Not too bad through pool play, Robbie. 3-4.
Yep.
Bad Boys awaiting the winner of this one as they got a direct ticket to the second round. Oh, not that time. Chef Boy Jardine. Pyle with a dangerous pass. Wallace is able to track it down. And Wallace with it's a unique release he's got.
He does. Kind of takes him a little bit of time to get that thing up, and it is a different looking shot.
And he's got two ankle braces on.
Some big braces.
That's some extra reinforcement for guarding some of these crossovers. Back to the bucket. Headband Terry. Trying to get
that
a band.
That was the weight room.
Oh, good drive.
He saw it. He had a mismatch with Matt Pyle, and he just took him right to the basket.
Yeah, chit him. Using that
talk about mismatches. Well, that's a settle.
Yo.
It's not a very high percentage shot.
Yeah, not the best possession.
Especially when you just put him in the basket the possession before.
Right. And really, on elimination day, every possession counts. Yep. You want to move on and continue to have opportunities to win money. They gotta take a cerebral approach to the game. It's not all about the physicality.
But look at the difference in possessions. We've seen Terry Taylor go to the rack. They can't guard him. He settles for the fadeaway contested 20-footer. You're just bailing out the defense.
Yeah. Brown was suffocated. Forced a tough shot late in the shot clock.
Go back to the rim. Well, that's another contested two.
Here's Cody John, former Weber State Wildcat. Set up a working on Pyle here. Hezzy, spin. Hey.
Nice. Okay. Right over Isaiah Brown.
Wallace is comfortable in that mid-range area, but he just ran up and got splashed in the face. Brown gave it to him. 12-10 is where we stand. We got 3 second round matchups already set. Tobacco Road Riders against the Dirty South. Colonial Connection against Horizon Valley Hoopers. American Made advance to meet Beast Coast Ballers. And we're going to see who advances to meet the Bad Boys. Scanlon kicks it. Terry Taylor, get off me. Goes off the rim.
Rebound. Dug that one out.
Yeah, Jardine came out with it. Cody John, too much protein on the J. Now he's going to try his luck. Oh, maybe he's going to head to the other side. Oh, yeah, nice dribble move. But man, Pyle was painted on him.
He was. He moved his feet. Cody John thought he got fouled. I thought it was a good D. Matt Pyle moving the puppies and guarding.
Lockdown. Under 4 minutes to go. And another close one. Every game today decided by 2 points or less. A couple of overtime games, except for that HBCU Don't Want None getting beat down by Colonial Connection. That was a 10-point contest. We'll see how this one plays out. Again, with 3:39 officially left. What can Brown do for you? Nothing. Not on that possession.
You look at Summit Valley Hoopers, they go 1-6, but their win came against a really good Big Maction team.
A signature dub for sure.
Their only dub.
Yes.
Signature and only.
Signature and singular.
But, you know, you beat a team like that, you can beat anybody in this field. Yeah. Big Maction's one of the favorites of the Dos Equis Lounge. I know there's a lot of those, but I think you have to say that Big Maction would be one of the top two or three teams here.
Yeah, for sure. I do like Big Maction. Obviously, the Wicked Smots is a large favorite. But
Rocky
my favorite.
Rocky Mountain Range.
My favorite is Rocky Mountain Range.
The New Williams effect.
I know that they are top heavy, but sometimes we got a player that dynamic. I mean, he just takes your team to the
just
next
cooking.
Tier. Yeah, he is. Oh, I see you. I see you, Robbie.
Be like you,
I see you, Robbie. There's Brown. Too strong. Chittum. Trying to set the screen. He does. Gets a little bit more space for Jeff Jardine.
Yeah.
He's simmering.
Some big shots there. There's that fake handoff. That breaks you off. Taking it under the legs and then gets that pull-up and pick and roll action. And all of a sudden, Chef's got back-to-back buckets.
Oh, look at that bucket.
That is a tough shot. I mean, you'll live with that if you're Chittum. Chef's making every play right now Western Skywalker.
Yeah, he is.
He's really making things happen.
Chef Boy Jardine is setting the table. We can keep trading them off, Robbie.
We're hot right now.
We are.
You're always hot, but all of a sudden I found my rhythm too.
Absolutely.
Oh, Chef didn't like the no call. He thought Terry Taylor got him on the arm.
Yeah.
Hart said,
no way.
Nope. Let's take a look. You be the judge. He might have had an argument there.
Yeah, whenever the defender is looking at the ref saying, I didn't do it, usually that's a sure sign of guilt.
Yes. We got a one-point game. Summit Valley open.
Oh, nice.
They have just Chef Boy Jardine.
Jardine is killing.
He is cooking.
So is Terry Taylor. They are trading buckets.
They're trading recipes.
This would be a big upset. I know we talked about how Summit Valley Open got big action, but still, Western Skywalkers 3-4, Summit Valley Open 1-6. Once again, Terry Taylor, 9 points, one of the biggest scorers in this event. Kyle's boy, Chef Day Jardine, has 8 himself.
How many assists does he have?
5 rebounds, 1 assist.
Okay.
One assist might not be right, but Terry Taylor is living at the rim, as he should.
He's a bucket. Oh, step back.
Boy Jardine.
Ooh. Oh, he might be in trouble here.
Oh, wow.
He bailed him out.
He did. He totally bailed him out.
We got a minute and a half to play. Jardine.
Oh.
Chittum. Could not knock that one down. It stays a two-point game. Approach that 1 minute mark. Josiah Wallace.
Nice cross.
Yeah,
oh,
cross.
Chef just staying in the play.
Oh, he's making Cody plays John. All over the court.
Big
setting
shot.
Up Cody John. CJ with the double dip and
the D.
The lockdown D.
Well, that was nice.
Oh, great play.
Big sequence for Cody John.
16-16. He loves operating from that right corner over there.
Boy, making every play over the last three possessions is Cody John.
Cody John stepping up big time.
Oh, smart by Terry Taylor.
Oh! Two-piece and a biscuit. Terry Taylor is going to put his squad in front. And I was about to say a bad shot, but dang.
Not when it goes.
I'm glad that I shut up. Just let him do what he does.
You know, he got the defender in the air with the ball fake. Chittum leaves his feet. And the bank is open.
What a high degree of difficulty on that two-make. He does not make the free throw.
Jardine tried to steal an easy look, and they end up giving up an offensive rebound. Boy, that was super high in the air.
And he just barely missed that thing. Oh, Josiah Wallace.
Oh, he just rushed that.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, that's a foul. Terry Taylor got Cody John right across the face. I feel like Summit Valley Open has missed some opportunities to give them a little more of a cushion here. Up one. 30 seconds to play. And it should be two or three.
Yeah, they've wasted a couple of possessions for sure. As good as Terry Taylor has been, I'm not hating on him. But you think back to a couple of those possessions.
He loves shooting those contested twos.
He loves shooting those contested twos off one leg fading in the corner.
And it's like it's amazing his release because he really curls that thing back, which has got to be hard to control.
Really? And it's kind of a slow wind up.
It's like a slow roller back, and then he just slings it.
But I tell you, though, even the ones that he misses, a lot of them look when he's wide open. The contestant was a tough one. The ones that he's missing, it just barely just coming
out. No, he's had some tough looks go in and out. It's got to be Chef's time, right?
Absolutely.
Well, Cody John has done some really good things, too, and he's going to get a wide-open layup. So.
Take what the D gives you.
It's got to be Terry Taylor time.
18 all. 18 seconds remaining.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. You got 8 seconds. Get the ball to Terry Taylor and let him go to work.
Josiah Wallace down to Taylor. He's working on Jardine.
Oh, the post double comes and a great pass.
Vision. Draws the double team. Cody John leads it short. They got 5 seconds to go.
What is going on? What is going
on? Taylor forces it up. John, last second heat, but it's going to be a W for Summit Valley Open. 19-18 as they just barely hold off the Western Skywalkers. And Terry Taylor and company, headband Terry. He's got a new band, and it ain't on his head, it's in his hands. As the cash is flying, $1,000 worth. Scanlon a happy man too. He's been a working man for the past year. And he gets a pay raise. And that's your go-ahead bucket right there. It's a great vision from Terry Taylor. That's what happens when you're a bucket. You draw so much attention, opens up opportunities for your teammates, and opens up a spot on the couch in the Dos Equis Lounge with the Duffel Bag Boys.
Is this the first time we've seen these guys?
I think this is your first time in the second time.
Okay. Well, I want to start. I mean, let's point out the obvious. You guys are not probably considered favorites in this thing. The pool play.
Says who?
That's probably. That's what I want to ask you. The pool play says the pool play. You guys did not necessarily play particularly well the first 2 days. You come out, you get the big dub. Was there something different about today versus the last 2 days down?
Man, we come from conferences that's been overlooked. And, you know, we got that chip on our shoulder. We came out here to prove that we're going to ruin some of y'all's predictions.
Love it.
And just come out here and play and show that we belong in the quarterfinals, that the pool play, you know, we just getting used to it.
And Terry, can we talk about this two-pointer and the and one that you got right here? Great pump fake, great play, and then you get that dap on the sideline. What was that moment like? How'd that feel to get that to go down?
Just feeling hot, man. You know, I see a couple go, and I just feel like, you know, can't nobody guard me.
And then you get doubled, and we got the cut to the basket. Great cut to the basket. Great finish. I mean, it was a beautiful display there at the end of the game, guys.
Appreciate it.
I'm curious, the game strategy, obviously you guys didn't – we were playing to 21. You guys did not get to 21 because the clock ran out. How much – like, at what moment do you start to think about that and say, wait a second, maybe we should run
the
clock here?
Let's use the clock in our favor.
What's the strategy there?
We were just trying to limit their twos, make them drive it. Because that's how we've been getting beat most of the time, is people just keep shooting twos and making them and getting wide open ones. So we try to crowd their space and just make them make tough ones.
And we just try to get an early lead and then run them off the two-point line. And we'll beat them with ones. We just can't let them beat us with twos.
I love it. This is a great strategy.
You got Bad Boys up next. Yep. You know anything about them? They weren't in your pool, right?
Yeah, no. They got us first time.
They were. They beat you guys first time.
Yeah,
is that a good thing? Maybe they're gonna overlook you. They said we beat them already. What's your guys' thoughts going into that one?
We know we gotta come out strong. We didn't come out. We came out kind of sluggish, and they blitzed us like 18 to 5 or something crazy like that, and we wasn't prepared for it. So I think we know what they're capable of now, so we're going to be ready to go.
I tell you what, you hit more of these and-ones from
I think you guys will be okay.
I think you guys will be all right. Well, good to see you guys again. Congratulations on Big Win.
Come back to the lab.
They are here. Robbie, Kyle, they are here to disrupt your predictions.